End of World War II, Czechoslovak industry faces a challenge to construct a cheap, low-weight tractor suitable for mass production. This was a rational and clear idea. The head of the technological department of the National Committee commissioned František Musil in June 1945 to fulfill the task. Musil faced several obstacles which he had to overcome within record time, in 6 months. The pressure on the project was high. Musil himself worked day and night and knew how to inspire his team with his own enthusiasm and work discipline, despite the low financial remuneration of the post-war period. The competitors for the role of the sole future manufacturer of tractors included Zbrojovka Brno and Škoda Plzeň. The trial comparison was scheduled for a Saturday in November. That was the beginning of the history of the world-famous Czech producer of agricultural machinery. Musil's prototype Z became the winner.
Quieten down, young man. This is a museum, and there should be peace.
I can't help it. It's funny. Look at these funny vehicles. Were people not scared to climb up on these? And that name, Zetor.
Come, come. That, in your words, funny name, is known all around the world. Why, Zetors have helped farmers from Alaska to Australia, from India to Inchtur. They are remarkable for their long life, reliability, ease of maintenance, and their versatility.
Don't be ridiculous. The thing hasn't even got a roof.
After the war, all tractors were convertibles. Cabs didn't become the norm until much later. And it's no accident that the first safety cabins were developed by Zetor. I see you have some large gaps in your education. So listen up. It all began on the 15th of March, 1946. František Musil and his team had managed to put together a prototype for a new Czechoslovak tractor in 6 months. And that day, the first Z25 rolled off the production line. A year later, 3,500 tractors had been sold, and production was increasing. Zetors were sold to Ireland, Poland, Denmark, Belgium.
And what's the origin of the name Zetor?
Zetor? Well, the first part, Z, is the Czech letter Z, the symbol for Brno's Zbrojovka. And the last two letters, O-R, are the last letters in tractor.
Interesting. What else have you got?
Well, there's plenty more, but everything in its proper order. First the first, then the second, and then the third.
On the 15th of March 1946, the Zbrojovka Brno factory held a small celebration. On that day, the first three Z25 tractors were delivered to customers. Exactly 5 months later, Zetor received a trademark to protect the brand. And how was the name itself born? Like all congenial things, easily and simply, as the transcript of the letter Z, used in the logo of the Brno Zbrojovka engineering plant, where the first tractors were made, combined with the last two letters of the word tractor. The tractor was introduced to the public at an agricultural exhibition in Prague in the same year. In the year 1947, nearly 3,500 tractors were sold, about one-third to Ireland, Poland, Denmark, and Belgium. The number was not low, despite a manufacturing capacity of 28 tractors a day during that period. Certain reserves were found in the absence of manufacturing, especially machining tools. And so the search for tools began across the country. They were eventually found underground, in the caves of the Moravian Karst near Brno, where the Nazis had built workshops for their war production. In the years 1947 to 1949, 2,215 Zetor 15 tractors were made. This was a single-cylinder prototype of the Zetor 25. The Zetor 15 was equipped with a diesel engine with a power of 15 horsepower, or 11 kilowatts, a six-gear transmission, and maximum speed of 22 kilometers per hour. František Musil continued to innovate his product. He looked for inspiration abroad. The result was a new embodiment of his tractor, the Zetor 25K, the K standing for cultivation. The first tractor made in 1948 was sold on the Polish market. Changes in comparison to the type Z25 mainly concerned the transmission and the rear wheels. This tractor was constructed for crops planted in lines. Musil possessed a lot of experience in designing diesel engines. The demand of the time resulted in his proposed tractor, Zetor 30. The tractor used the direct injection system, as one of the first in the world, for fuel consumption reduction and was equipped with a hydraulic plow lift with a new construction. The tractor received the gold medal at the agricultural exhibition in Prague in 1948. But in the same year, production was stopped following an order to that effect issued by the National Committee. The National Committee decided that tractors of higher power categories were needed. Thus, the award was swept to the floor. In the course of more than 2 years, the Zetor 25 gathered a lot of operational experience in different countries. The result of the modernization based on this experience was the Zetor 25A, differentiated from the Model 25K in 1949, with several benefits: an improved dashboard, including a thermometer, a comfortable upholstered seat, three-point hydraulic hitch, cab to order, differential lock, an adjustable front and rear wheelbase. In February 1949, the first 10,000 tractors were sold. The model Zetor 25 reached 8,500 manufactured units. Despite that, neither domestic nor foreign demand was fully satisfied. Apart from tractors, Zbrojovka Brno also focused on other production: motorcycle engines, firearms, typewriters. This limited the volume of tractor production. After the war, the company purchased premises in the eastern outskirts of the city, since 1942 used by the German aircraft engine manufacturer Flugmotorenwerke Ostmark. The plant needed to be reconstructed, and most of it had been destroyed by Allied bombing. Zbrojovka first transferred the manufacture of textile machines there, but then transferred the Z25 tractor production to the Lishen premises appeared more convenient. This was in 1952.
Look! Look what I found! Come on! Come on!
What have you got there?
Be careful it doesn't knock you out. This is really powerful. Okay, it's fine. Tractor, guy, sit on it. But watch how he goes down the slope. He's off. He won't make it. Ah, that's a disaster! He must be completely destroyed. And why are they even showing it like this? Ugh! Just you keep laughing at this unfortunate scene. The tractor written off, and you...
Right, cease this silliness. It's clear even to you that this is just a test, and that your body is just a dummy, and that the tractor didn't make it, as you said. I would take a careful look at Zetor tractors. There was, for the time, a strong emphasis placed on driver safety. Zetor was the first in the world to have protective frames. And if there was no other way to do it, then Zetor were prepared to completely destroy a tractor, just to prove that the construction was strong enough. Some of these elements have become obsolete, but they thought about building a tractor not only in terms of performance and driver comfort. Zetor led the world in this. And by the way, have you noticed?
What? I can't see anything.
Just take a good look at this fall of several feet. And as the bottom tractor starts normally, off he goes. Of course, except for the burst tire.
Unbelievable.
And that's not everything, dear boy. Come and look at this rarity, the dancing tractor.
In the year 1954, the research and development base at Zetor was established, using the knowledge and experience of engineers of Zbrojovka Brno. Their first result was the Zetor Super 35, a tractor with a four-cylinder diesel engine with a power of 42 horsepower, or 31 kilowatts. Two new elements, a central axle with blade springs and a sprung driver's seat, increased user comfort. The driver's cab was equipped with heating. In the years 1955 to 1960, 21,500 tractors of this type were produced. Lack of hydraulic hitch systems for axle load relief and the slow development of suitable tractor tires in the 50s were the main reasons for increased demand for crawlers. Zetor reacted to the demand in 1956 with a crawler embodiment of the Zetor 35, known as the Zetor Super P, first introduced at the second exhibition of Czechoslovak engineering industry at the Brno Fairgrounds. The weight of the crawler was nearly double the weight of the non-crawler version. Around 4,200 units were made up to 1958. In 1959, two new assembly lines were installed, one for the assembly of Zetor 35 Super engines, and the other for the final assembly of this tractor type. The two lines later merged. In 1960, the Super 35 tractor was modernized and renamed the Super 50. These tractors were sold as far afield as Burma, Ghana, and Iraq. By 1968, more than 150,000 units had been produced. In the latter half of the 1950s, Zetor was the first in the world to introduce the progressive and unique concept of using unified elements in tractor manufacture, i.e. the concept allowing the use of identical parts for different models, which considerably simplified both manufacture and servicing. In 1960, the Zetor 3011 tractor was launched as the basic model for the revolutionary unified series UR1. Now it became possible to develop series including a wide range of models and embodiments.
Excuse me, do you have a moment?
Of course, what do you need?
Here is a word which I don't understand at all. Zetormatic. No, wait, I see it. This is probably some kind of automatic robotic tractor.
If only something like that existed. But that's not far from the truth. Zetormatic was a system for controlling the inner hydraulic circuit set, for adjusting equipment with positional, power, and reaction speed regulation.
Wait, I need English.
Excuse me, but it's actually elegant and simple. Zetormatic was a simple system which automatically adjusted the depth of the plow according to the resistance of the soil. In addition, it transferred the weight of the plow onto the rear axle of the tractor.
So, this meant that the tractor tended to slip and skid less, thus saving fuel.
Great. You see, you're finally getting it. Moreover, control was very easy, and when the driver learned to use the Zetormatic system properly, they were able to plow more accurately and quickly, with less expense on fuel and less wear and tear on the tractor.
Wow. Great gadgets for 1960.
Gadgets?
Like totally cutting edge.
Well, for its time, it was a revolutionary innovation. Zetormatic toured the world with Zetor tractors. It was no laughing matter to produce the necessary parts. For Zetormatic to work properly, everything had to be accurate to thousandths of a millimeter. And every piece that was tested had to last a million repetitions. And for such precise and demanding production, it was necessary to have perfectly trained workers. Zetor even had its own training facility. Check it out yourself. By 1975, it had already been running for 25 years.
Together with the first models of the UR1 series, the year 1960 saw the introduction of the Zetormatic, a hydraulic lifting system with automatic depth control, allowing for the transfer of part of the weight of the pulled implement on the rear tractor axle, and thus improved traction.
So when will it be?
When will what be?
The dancing tractor you promised.
Don't fret, any moment now. They're just about ready.
Yeah, it's coming. You were right, it's a cracking wheeze. You can see these Zetor chaps know how to have fun.
This is no joke. This is a regular longevity test.
Longevity test? What?
You see, before a new prototype tractor...
As of 1961, 16 years after the start of serial production, the total number of manufactured units was 158,570 of the Z25 type, of which 97,000 were exported across the world. There were not many world tractor brands that could compare to this result. Zetor responded to customer requirements for increased tractor power. To support the development of a stronger tractor, the Czechoslovak-Polish Tractor Research Center was founded in 1962, with its seat in the Zetor plant in Brno.
I've completely lost the plot here.
What don't you understand this time?
First was the Zetor Z25, and then models derived from it. Then came the Unified Range 1.
This is the Zetor 3011.
So what now? Here we go again. I see Zetor 4011 and 2011. I don't get it.
Calm down. It's completely elementary. The Zetor 3011 was from 1960. With the Unified Range 1, there came a new naming convention for the models. The first two digits are the performance in horsepower. The third digit identifies the drive axles. 1, one drive axle. 2, tracks. 3, flexible wheel. And 4, drive on both axles. And the fourth digit identifies the type of tractor. 1, universal tractor. 2, cultivator. 3, a narrow track. And so on.
Oh, so 3011 means a universal tractor with single axle drive and 30 horsepower.
Exactly. And because Zetor was trying its best to meet customer requirements, the second and third model in the Unified Range were launched in 1962 and 1963.
The 40 horsepower, 4011, and the 20 horsepower, 2011.
You see, when you make a bit of effort, it's not too bad with you. As a reward, I'll take you on a long journey. But first, a look at the puzzle tractor.
On the basis of the economic policy of the political formation of the period, Czechoslovakia began to cooperate with Poland in the field of tractor manufacture. In the year 1964, Zetor provided documentation for the UR1 models to help modernize tractors of the Polish company Ursus. A year later, manufacture was launched of the Ursus C4011 tractor, which was manufactured until 1992 with continuous modernization. Well now, let's see.
Wait, don't tell me anything. This I'm sure, let me guess. It's a celebration of the 10,000th tractor made, isn't it?
I'm afraid I have to disappoint you. You're completely wrong. Firstly, we're somewhere in 1964, and Zetor has made over 200,000 tractors, of which more than half were exported. And secondly, you mustn't forget this was the era of communism.
So what am I supposed to know?
Why, it's Labor Day, the 1st of May. And because Zetor was a large, important manufacturer, it absolutely had to be at the parade. After all, delegations came to watch from all over the world.
Hey, you're right. Here's one being welcomed now. Where's he from?
This is a delegation from Poland. Zetor was in constant contact with Polish constructors. In Poland, tractors were produced under the name Ursus, and experts from Zetor contributed to their development. And they were produced there until 1992. In England, at the time, the biggest manufacturer of tractors in the world, Zetor was the most popular imported tractor. Indeed, let's see where Zetor wandered.
Puzzle Zetor? I'm sure you'll explain.
As we said, Zetor traveled from Brno all over the world. There was huge demand for Zetor, from France, Germany, England, and even further afield, India, Burma, Iraq, Africa, Vietnam. How could they reduce these enormous transport costs? What about the danger of damage during transit?
So they turned them into a puzzle.
Exactly. Here's a giant Zetor puzzle being prepared for export. First of all, they dismantled the wheels, mudguards, and exhaust so that they were more stackable. But over time, as demand increased from places like Japan or India, an entire assembly line was created, which Zetor delivered in a box with all the necessary parts. And from these, local workers under Czech supervision produced a whole Zetor factory.
And this paid off for a few exported tractors, did it?
The question is, what do you call a few? In Japan, for example, they produced thousands of tractors. Similarly, in India, there the local company over time completely took over the production and started to sell their own tractors. And from the Czech Zetor, they founded the Indian Zebra. But that's all just history. Let's look to the future. Look, Crystal is coming. How to expand overseas without the risk of high cost of transport? A good solution seems to be local assembly based on licensing contracts with local manufacturers. This was a task for Motokov, the state-owned import and export agency. Zetor thus helped motorize agriculture in countries in Asia, the Middle East, and South America. Assembly lines were built in Burma, India, and Iraq, producing more than 200,000 tractors in the years 1964 to 1993. In 1966, the UR1 series was extended with the largest model 5511 with a power of 52 horsepower or 38 kilowatts. The tractor boasted a modern and impressive look. In addition to its design, it represented other innovations as well. A new engine, a better torque, a rigid U-profile front axle, hydraulic steering booster, and a new dashboard. A very important optional accessory was the cab, which protected the driver if the tractor toppled over. The UR1 was modernized in 1967, according to the recommendation of West European representatives of Zetor. The following year saw the launch of new models, the 2511, 3511, and 4511. More than 80,000 tractors of this series were sold. The demand for higher power brought about the first model of the UR2 series. Mass production began in 1968. A number of new features and solutions, not very common at that time, placed Zetor among the leading world tractor manufacturers. The first safety cab in this industry, secured against toppling over and mounted on silent blocks. The four-cylinder engine was equipped with balancing spindles, leading to another world first. The noise level in the cab for the first time dropped below 85 decibels. The torque multiplier allowed for gear selections under load and doubling of the gears by increased traction force of the tractor. In its time, Crystal was one of the first tractors for heavy operation with this early multiplier type. The square design and operation ergonomics evoke robustness and comfort.
It's coming. Crystal is coming.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
You said Crystal is coming, and I said it would be a great name for a Bond film.
What are you talking about?
How can I explain it? He's like this guy who can do anything.
Just like the Zetor Crystal, production number 7511. It was the first model of the new Unified Range 2, launched in 1968. The Crystal name came about as a trade name for export.
7511? So a nice performance. 75 HP.
There was a lot of demand for high-powered tractors, so a few months after the Crystal arrived, there was another model with 80 horsepower. But that wasn't the only new thing. The Crystal had roll protection for the cab, the first in its category. It was on silent blocks, so that the sound level in the cab was below 85 decibels. In its time, Zetor had one of the most comfortable cabs in the world. Zetor was synonymous with solidness, comfort, and power. Zetor, that was something. In 1968, and just the same today.
In the years 1968 to 1974, Zetor tractors were supplied to the Japanese company Iseki. They were supplied equipped with cage wheels and a special brake system for work in the water of the rice fields. 7 years of cooperation resulted in the supply of around 4,000 tractors. The largest foreign manufacturing plant of Zetor was built in Iraq, in the industrial park of the state enterprise Mechanical Industries, in the city of Iskandaria. Under difficult Iraq conditions, Zetor tractors gained a high reputation, and as a result, a long-term supply contract. From 1970, Zetor tractors began to be manufactured under the brand name Antar. The last disassembled tractors were supplied there in 1990. In 1971, the largest Indian manufacturer of machine tools, Hindustan Machine Tools, executed a licensing contract with Motokov for the local manufacture of the Zetor 2511 under the brand name HMT. The tractor established itself and models with higher power were demanded. In 1990, cooperation was closed and HMT took over the whole tractor manufacturer. UR1 tractors have been modernized since the first series launch. In 1972, the 7 series began to be manufactured with the basic models 4711, 5711 and 6711, and then also with the double-cylinder model 2511. The tractors featured a robust and yet comfortable, silent and safe cab. They were sturdier and achieved higher power. 99,000 of this series were sold. In 1975, the first six-cylinder model, the 12011, was launched, also available as model 12045, with a propelled front axle. You see,
it's just an ordinary school.
This is no ordinary school. This is a vocational school, where Zetor started to operate in 1950. The success of Zetor was always built upon quality work and looking after your workers. That was vital to Zetor.
To produce tractors there, not much else that I have to learn, hey?
You'd be surprised. Why, we've already said that in the production of parts for the Zetor-matic, they had to have a precision of...
To the nearest...
To a thousandth of a millimeter. For that, you need to know your technology. But you also need experience and lots of feeling. Pupils could practice everything directly, right here on the production line. When you finished school, they were perfectly prepared to go right into production. There were also extra classes for gifted students. These continued on to university, who were recruited as future masters or as staff trainers or for the service centers abroad. And in addition, there were also special courses such as operational electrician.
Operation electrician?
A line like this one in Zetor would have to be running 7 days a week in order to meet domestic and international demand. Without electricity, it would not work. And in the event of a problem, waiting for someone from outside would be really expensive. So Zetor had its own electricians, capable of solving problems immediately. Whatever a chap can't get done himself. Thanks to this, Zetor was able to be in top form. In 1976, the name of the Lishen factory changed from the original ZKL, ball bearing manufacturing plants, Brno, to Zetor Brno. From 1977, the portfolio included the Series 9 UR1 with the basic models 4911, 5911 and 6911. Modernization again focused on driver comfort, with an excellent design and construction of the cab, and likewise the dashboard. The cab was heated and provided with inside noise reduction.
The year 1979 brought a record number of manufactured tractors in the history of the Zetor brand. In total, 32,670 tractors came off the production line. In 1980, another modernization of the Series UR1, the Series 10, became available. The tractors offered higher power at lower fuel consumption and improved transmission with a wider gear range. The color of the paintwork also changed. The wheel rims were white instead of red, and the bodywork changed from beige to dark green. In that year, there was another major change. A new Zetor logo replaced the simplified depiction of a cannon barrel used until then. In 1980, the Unified Range 2 series was extended with the model 160-45 Turbo with four-wheel drive and a power of 160 horsepower, or 118 kilowatts. Negative development was brought to Brno in the year 1981, and then in harmony with the political move of the Czechoslovak government, manufacture of the crystal tractors was transferred to ZTS, heavy engineering plants, in Martin, Slovakia, after Brno having produced around 44,000 units. In Martin, innovative types of these tractors were made under the ZTS brand with three subsequent modernizations.
I've got you. Even a master makes a mistake sometimes.
Don't tell me.
Just have a look. Shall we talk about Zetor? And here you have some pictures of a foundry.
Your idea is good, but once again I have to disabuse you of a notion. This foundry belonged to Zetor and was even in the immediate vicinity of the area.
And why?
Do you know how many tractor parts have to be accurately produced at a foundry? The motor block, the gearbox, weights, and lots of other things. And everything depends on the quality of the casting. In order to have the best quality and avoid problems of transport and quality control, Zetor built its own foundry, which provided exactly what the factory needed.
And these are the 70s?
It was a time of a managed economy, and Zetor wasn't able to make all its decisions itself. In the 1970s, part of the production was moved to Slovakia. The changes in the organization of production meant that part of the tractors in 1981 began to be made at ZTS, the heavy engineering plant in Martin. Following transfer of manufacture of the Unified Range 2 Crystal series to Slovakia, the Unified Range 1 became the most important part of the Zetor portfolio. Straight away in 1984, a new series was introduced, the Series 2, with the basic models 5211, 6211, and 7211. The series was provided with a new engine, allowing the front power takeoff shaft driven from the rear end of the crankshaft. This series was further extended with short wheelbase vehicles for vineyards and vehicles with a lowered center of gravity for work on sloping terrain. The 7245H tractor was equipped with a warning system monitoring exceeded slope gradient and a safety cap. In 1989, the model 7711 began to be manufactured with four-wheel drive, including a turbo embodiment with 88 horsepower or 65 kilowatts.
Clop, 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 clop.
I'm afraid to ask, but what are you playing at here?
Why, it's 115 horses, galloping across the land.
I can see only one horse, but it's worth it.
Well, exactly.
But we're only teasing, aren't we? Look out, we're in the middle of the 90s, and here at Zetor there's hellfire and thunder. The new Unified Range 3, as well as the models with 75, 85, and 95 horsepower, are models with respectable power, 105 and 115. Zetor has a new higher-powered tractor to replace the aging crystals. In the early 90s, the absence of tractors in the medium power range was resolved. In 1991, models of the new series, Unified Range 3, namely the 7520, 7540, 8520, 8540 Turbo, and the 9520, 9540 Turbo were developed. In the mid-90s, a full-fledged replacement of the crystal eventually appeared, represented by the models 10540 with 105 horsepower, or 77 kilowatts, and the 11540 with 115 horsepower, or 85 kilowatts. The Unified Range 3 substantially differed from the Unified Range 1, equipped with more powerful engines, a transmission with power shift, rear axles for heavy loads, and modern massive cabs with wide field of vision. This series was first introduced in 1992. The constructors again considered the main attributes: higher performance, reliability, and comfort.
This series consisted of the models 3320, 3340, 4320, 4340, 5320, 5340, 6320 and 6340, and 7320 and 7340 turbo. Engine power ranges from 52 to 82 horsepower, or 38 to 60 kilowatts. On the 1st of July 1993, parts of the assets of the state-owned Zetor was transferred to the joint stock company Zetor AS, whose majority share was held by the Consolidation Bank.
Green and yellow Zetor? This is crazy, no? Zetor has always been red.
It's called the green-yellow Zetor because it came out in cooperation with the American company John Deere. Zetor produced tractors from 1993 to 1996 for them for Latin America. And John Deere's are green and yellow.
Aha!
But while we're talking about colors, Zetor is now unmistakably red. You're right. But at the beginning, Zetors were produced in military colors. Here, of course, there are some exceptions. For exports, they made some changes based on customer requirements. Japan wanted orange tractors, and this green 2041 was intended for Brazil. Later, Zetor produced a series in blue for export to the east, and red for export to the west.
I don't know. All the same, Zetors look best red.
An example of modern technology based on the traditional tractor shape of the 1950s. This in particular concerned five new models from 1997. 3321, 3341, 4321 and 4341, 5321, 5341, 6321 and 6341, and 7321 and 7341T. The tractors were driven by 3 and 4 cylinder engines with a power from 45 to 82 horsepower, or 33 to 60 kilowatts, with 2 and 4 wheel drive. The modern appearance was not the only benefit. Further improvements concerned hydraulics, new modern cab design, including a side gear lever, higher speed range, and extended selection of optional accessories.
Řazení, možnost vyšší rychlosti a rozšířený výběr příslušenství.
Zetor is super!
Zetor is not super. Well, it is, but...
It's written here, Zetor is super.
No, no, it's the name of the model, the super.
Wait a mo, it's now 1997, and super. That from the 50s, no?
VW also produced their Beetle from 1938. The new super continues the tradition of older models, primarily in quality and the wide range of power. They naturally have a modern look, a wide range of equipment, improved hydraulics, and lots of gadgets. You see what you've learned? Development did not stop in the case of the Unified Range 3 series either. The series was significantly modernized and in 1998 relaunched under the commercial name of Forterra. Unlike the current models of the Unified Range 3, the Forterra was manufactured exclusively with four-wheel drive. The first series included steel bodywork with moderate downward inclination. The heaviest model was the 11641, with a six-cylinder engine with a power of 115 horsepower, or 85 kilowatts. The second Forterra series then offered six models in the power range from 80 to 130 horsepower, or 59 to 96 kilowatts, and emission level stage 3. The wheel rim color has changed to light gray. In the years 1998 to 1999, nearly half of the shares held by the Consolidation Bank were purchased by Motorcorp. Unfortunately, tractor manufacture was stopped for lack of operational capital. In 1999, Zetor again needed to react to the demands of the time. A decision was made in favor of a particular solution. The series Unified Range 3, with medium power, continued to be produced for the European and North American markets, and the Unified Range 1 was designed for the Russian and African markets. Markets focused on cost saving were offered a low-cost tractor of the major series with a modern appearance, a power range from 59 to 84 horsepower, or 43 to 62 kilowatts, and optional safety cap. Its manufacture was discontinued in 2006.
Být vybaven i bezpečnostní kabinou. Jeho výroba bude ukončena v roce 2006.
I have to confess, that surprised me a lot.
And how's that?
I thought that Zetor was boring. But I've had a look around and found out that Zetor is a serious legend. Lots of people, and not just those working with them, genuinely live for tractors. a loving home for old-timers and classics, which puts on parades and get-togethers.
Well, you see, Zetor, it's a matter of the heart, you know. It's not just about products. Zetor could always boast lots of talented people. But when you see your tractor improved and new things working in practice, the tractor really working in the field, the forest, the vineyard, you feel such a swell of pride. And even more so when it's in the hands of someone who really knows how to drive one. You saw, for example, that there is a ploughing world championships, which has been going on since 1953. And it is a real science. To check the straightness of the rows, the consistency of depth, the turn of the soil, so that there are no straws or green sods showing. It's a real art form. Zetor's interest doesn't end when the tractor comes off the line, but continues into the field. And that is the end.
What do you mean, the end? Now I'm going to show you the power of Zetor.
At the turn of the millennium, Zetor underwent several changes. In 2000, a revitalization program was adopted. The Motikov share was again transferred back to the Consolidation Bank, and its subsidiary, Revitalizacni Traktor, SRO, Revitalization Traktor, Limited Liability Company. The company partly stabilized with its main objective to find a suitable strategic partner. On the 22nd of April 2002, the government of the Czech Republic approved the sale of the state share to HTC Holding, which on the 29th of June of the same year became 98% owner of Zetor. HTC Holding immediately began financial stabilization of the company, together with massive restructuring. The fundamental project successfully implemented in Zetor covered warehouse reduction, building of a modern manufacturing plant with effective management and cost saving. In 2007, the portfolio of Zetor was extended with the Proxima Plus series, equipped with front and rear axle for heavy loads. New elements included a tilting bonnet, allowing for easy access to the oil, fuel, and air filters. Towards the end of 2008, manufacture commenced of the tractor named Proxima Power, with three new four-cylinder models equipped with an interesting novelty. A transmission with electro-hydraulic reverse gear selection, allowing for reverse gear shifting under load, the so-called power shuttle. In 2009, the power of this series reached 117 horsepower, or 86 kilowatts.
She's a beauty, those lines and that power.
Nice, very nice. But what model is this?
You don't know? I'm enjoying this. Well, this is the new Proxima Power. Its production started in 2008. The power in the name means that it has performance of up to 117 horsepower. The Proxima series are all about customer comfort. They come with front and rear axles for heavy loads, with a tipping bonnet, which makes them easier to look after. The Proxima Power has a special feature, the power shuttle.
You and your gadgets.
But this will interest you. Power shuttle is a gearbox with electro-hydraulic reverse gears, which allows gear shifting in reverse under heavy loads. Zetor is a long way from being just history. But everyone already knows that.
In 2010, the newest offspring of the Forterra series was the model 135 with a new engine, the Z165 with 136 horsepower or 100 kilowatts power and a 16-valve cylinder head. The engines of the whole power range were homologated for stage 3. The new model series of Forterra tractors also distinguished itself with its interior design and equipment. A significant innovation was represented by the tilting bonnet of a brand new design. The style was close to the Proxima, with a square profile and identical circular headlights. The cab interior was distinguished with a new hydraulic control panel with covered control cables of hydraulic distributor. Zetor presented itself with a number of new developments and improvements. For 2011, they included new adaptations of the Proxima, Proxima Plus, and Proxima Power series. The tractors were provided with a new type identification with a zero at the end, where the first two digits represented engine power in horsepower, according to ISO 14396, without accessories. The main modernization element was the introduction of mechanical hydraulics with top link load sensing. The greatest difference from the Zetor hydraulics offered until then was represented by the absence of the inside cylinder. The layout of the main elements was also changed. The main functions of the mechanic hydraulics were controlled by a pair of levers located on the right of the cab. With regard to the new controls, the cab interior was also improved.
Electrical installations in the Proxima series were extended with a digital dashboard. In addition, all models of the Proxima series included sealed connectors for the major nodes and the option to extend the accessories with a heated rear windshield and rear view mirrors. In 2012, Zetor launched the Forterra 140 HSX. The tractor is equipped with state-of-the-art technology, the latest generation of the power shuttle, a new five-gear transmission with three-stage multiplier, heavy-duty hydraulics, hitchtronic LCD display, longer wheelbase for increased stability, and safety driver's seat.
Present arms! The legendary Zetor Major is back. With the Major, not only is the name of the popular 1960s model returning, but also the whole concept. A compact and powerful tractor, versatile and yet reliable. A little helper, but one designed to handle large jobs. An excellent price-performance ratio, an easy-to-maintain, reliable four-cylinder engine, simply the ideal tractor for a small family farm, for instance. The Majors of the 1960s and those reintroduced in the 1990s were both big successes with customers, and there's every reason to expect the new Major to be just as successful. The third Major promises to be another hit. Instead of the originally estimated 900 units, Zetor will now be making 1,400 Majors in the first year of production, and even this is not enough to cover current demand. The Major will be the best-selling tractor in the Czech Republic, Slovakia and Poland. Enormous interest is also gathering around development of the Major 60 with 61 horsepower. Is Zetor simply a brand for small farmers? The Czech tractor manufacturer's response has been the Forterra HD model, with plenty of technical innovations aimed at increasing utility for customers and ensuring comfortable operation. The 150 horsepower engine surmounts every obstacle. Tens of tons of biomass on the trailer are child's play, and when working with a plow in the field, the latest generation of hitchtronic is invaluable. In 2012, this automated control of the rear three-point hitch instantly became that year's must-have gadget. At the pressing of a few buttons, you simply enter the tillage parameters and off you go. There is no complicated adjustment of the plow, on top of which you get a significantly lower fuel consumption. And it's not only Hitchtronic that is attracting more and more new customers to Forterra HD. The powerful engine works reliably in both scorching heat and during the hardest frost. And whether you are working flat out during harvest or clearing roads at minus 10, the new generation of electro-hydraulics, along with the stronger wheel drive assembly and the larger wheel track and wheelbase, all prove really useful. So, driving this Iron Lady, with its front suspended axle and comfortable cab, will always bring a smile to your face. Zetor customers are quickly learning a new English phrase, Zetor Crystal, the hard worker. And it is clear from the basic parameters of the reborn legendary Crystal model that the nickname Hard Worker has not been applied accidentally. It works hard under any conditions. With a six-cylinder engine of up to 163 horsepower, it is currently Zetor's most powerful tractor. Apart from performance and endurance, Zetor has prioritized Crystal's versatility. It can do anything, from mowing with a cutter bar to using mixer feeder wagons, not to mention towing a plow or pulling loads weighing dozens of tons. The gearbox with 30 forward and 30 reverse gears gives you optimal performance day and night, in summer as well as in the depths of winter. Zetor Crystal is simply a partner that will not let you down, even if you are out in the field all day long. And while it is working hard, you are driving in a soundproof and spring-suspended cab, able to fully concentrate on your work, no matter how tough the job is. The new Zetor Crystal? Hard worker says it all.
Hi, we're Zetor. For more than 70 years, we have been designing, developing, and loving tractors. From the very beginning, Zetor has been connected with the city of Brno, the second biggest city in the Czech Republic. The first Zetor tractor rolled off the Brno Zbrojovka production line on the 15th of March, 1946. In 1968, Zetor came out with the Unified Series 2, which had many breakthrough features, like the first safety cabin in the world. And in 1975, the first six-cylinder Zetor Crystal pulled out of the factory gates. In 1991, a new generation of modern tractors, designated as the Unified Series 3, was launched. 2002 was an important year for Zetor, when HTC Holding AS joined the company and the Zetor brand was saved and stabilized. The following period brought new models and products: Proxima, Forterra HSX with a hydraulic reverser, Major, Forterra HD. In 2015, the new six-cylinder 163 HP Zetor Crystal came out. The hard worker is the most powerful product in the range. The big result for Zetor during its history has been its great many satisfied customers all over the world. At Zetor, of course, we are more interested in the future, but not so distant. We are planning to increase our current portfolio by two new series to six series with power from 50 to 200 HP. We are working hard to develop our business network, and we're looking for new dealers to help us extend our network. We are investing in the development of new products, engines, transmissions, and so on. And we intend to continue this trend in the years to come. As we increase the number of our model series, we invest into modernizing production lines to prepare for increased demand in production. The future of the brand is epitomized by the Zetor by Pininfarina, an attractive, modern, elegant, and sexy design concept that will soon be introduced across all our tractor ranges. What do we offer our customers? Performance. Power usage is maximized thanks to a combination of engine power and the weight of the tractor. Endurance. The focus is on simple, smart, and efficient implementation. Total cost of ownership. Due to its very low fuel consumption and price availability of spare parts, it is hard to better Zetor in operating costs. Zetor is not just tractors. We offer our customers the Zetor System, a range of front loaders for all the model series and Zetor products. Zetor is a stable brand with a clear future, which ensures development and expansion products, active building of the dealer network, satisfied customers and employees. Because we are all Zetor.